for the discussion of data science, its application, what are the platforms, right, we can use to work on data science, what are the industries in which we can make our career after completing the data science, right, a machine learning engineer, data scientist, data engineer, like that, okay? That kinds of things that we are going to understand here. First of all, let me just give about little bit of idea about myself. So currently, I have more than 6 years of experience in working in the in industry as a data scientist. In my past, I had already worked with few of the major platforms in the education domain, and also for the data science, that what is basically data science is, right? So I hope most of you have gone through, right, that what is data science before this webinar. How many of you try to go through some part of data science? I've done some R&D on this. How many of you have done some R&D? Can you raise your hand? Or you can use the chat box. Simply give yes in the chat. Anyone, guys? Anyone did any research? Any sort of information you gather that what is data science? Okay. No issues. No issues. So let's see, for example, if you look for the data science definition online, so there are a lot of definition which is given. Okay, few are saying we are analyzing the data, we are creating some projects, some applications, right? All of that things are there. But what is the simplest definition of data science is, right? So first of all, we will understand that what we are going to do in this webinar. We will understand the field of data science, that what data science is all about, what is its importance, right? Then we will understand the application advantages and some a little bit of practical as well in the end of the session. Okay. Okay. Now, so a simplest definition of data science is that algorithm visualization. Okay, so there are three things, three terms we are coming with: the statistics, algorithm, and visualization. Now, what is model? We will talk about that later. Okay, what is model? We will talk about. Now, what is insight? Anyone? Reports. Okay. Anyone else? Janvi gave the answer that it's a report. Good. Anyone else? Any other answer? What is insight? Useful data. Okay. Good. Raw data. No, not Aman, not raw data. Okay. Not raw data. See, insight simply says hidden information. Okay. Getting my point? Insight means hidden information. For example, to understand this hidden information, how many of you know about the stock market? I hope everyone knows. Okay, what is the stock market? Right. Now tell me how many of you, good, how many of you able to understand the candle chart? How many of you find information from the candlestick chart? Correct. Not really. It's confusing. Right? It's confusing. But who knows how to read those candlesticks? They very well use them. Correct. That are very complicated. Correct. Right? But those who understand that how to you can say interpret those data, interpret those candles, right? They can use it and they can make money. Correct? Yes or no? So how they are doing this? Because from this candlestick, what they are doing, they are finding the information which is hidden. Right, which is hidden in the terms of candlestick. That is what we call as insight. Getting my point? Yes or no? Insight is clear? Everyone? Good. Now, coming on to the statistics. So statistics is basically a specific branch of mathematics which gives us functionality or functions to work with numbers. Now the common question arises that mathematics always work with number, then what is the specialty about this statistics, right? Understand, the specialty of this statistics is that we can do numerous tasks. For example, we can do hypothesis testing. We can do statistical test, right? We can also observe the behavior of data, or in technical terms we call it as distribution. Behavior of data or distribution. Now understand, let's say for example, let's say for a college which has thousands of students, right? Yearly score has generated and yearly score shown on the basis or using the histogram. So we are getting like this, something like this, let's say. Right? Now, what this histogram telling us, how to interpret this histogram, how to find information from this histogram? Not just the histogram, we have lots of you can say graphs as well, also like scatter plot is there, bar plot is there, pie chart is there, donut plot is there, right? So how to interpret them and finding the behavior of data, understanding the data behavior or distribution simply. That is the main task of understanding the statistics in data science. Getting my point? Clear, everyone? Anyone have any question or doubt till now? You can go ahead, guys. Otherwise, in the end of the session, we have a Q&A session. Good. Now, coming on to the next term, that is algorithm. That is algorithm. Now, what is algorithm? Anyone? What is algorithm? How a structure work or conditions. Okay, so before the algorithm, how many of you know about flow chart? In our elementary school, when we started with learning about the computer, the first thing that we learned is flow chart. Yes or no? Not predefined answer, Priyal. Okay, not predefined answers. See, what is flow chart? Flow chart is basically a step by step, you can say, a structure of a process. Okay, a structure of a process. Let's say, for example, a simple task is given. A simple task is given. And task is, let's say, boiling water. Right? Now understand. To boil the water, we require every step to be performed in synchronous way. Means, first, we will take the pan. After that, we fill it with water. Then put the pan on stove. Then open the stove. After that, light up the stove. Just a second, guys. Sorry for this. Hello, is that audible? This webinar going on. Yes. Okay. Fine. So we are discussing about the algorithm. Okay. So light up the stove and all that things. So what we are doing here, we are performing a step-by-step process. Okay. If I remove any of the step from here, is it possible to boil the water? Yes or no? Definitely not. No. Understand. Good. Now understand. If I compile all of this step, okay, in some mathematical form. Mathematical structure or mathematical form, then what we say, then it's an algorithm. So flow chart converted to the algorithm, correct? Which can be generalized for any process of boiling, right or not? Everyone clear what is algorithm? Good. And now the last thing, that is visualization. Now visualization simply says designing or representing your data or result using graphs or charts. That is what visualization says. Correct? Everyone clear? Yes, no. So to do this, we basically have two very you can say important tools which is very easy to learn as well, right? That is Tableau and Power BI. These are the two tools. Okay. So we will talk about them in the course. That what is Tableau, what is Power BI. Okay, now coming on to the next thing about the data science, right? So here is a quick you can say definition is given that it's a multidisciplinary field that uses scientific method, process, algorithm, and system to extract knowledge and insight from the structured and unstructured data. So basically, what is a structured data? Structured data is data that is available in the form of table, and unstructured data, that data which is available in the form of files. Okay, so how to get data from the structured and unstructured data, that comes under the part of data science as well. For this purpose, we use one very common platform that is called MySQL. Okay, MySQL we call it. We will understand that that what is MySQL and how to install and all that in the course curriculum, right? Another definition is given that a concept of unify statistics, data analysis, machine learning, and their related method. Unify means where everything is working in a unity to come up with a new data or to come up with a new result. Okay, that is the concept of basically the data science. Now, employ technique and theories drawn from many fields with the context of mathematics, statistics, computer science, and information science. What it says that we are not just working on a single domain. We have lots of domain that we are working with. We have aeronautical sector, we have e-commerce, we have healthcare domain, we have real estate sector, we have BFSI sector. Whatever industry you say, we are into that right now. Okay, data science is available in every industry currently. Correct? Now, coming on to that, why we are using it. Okay, when everything was going fine previous to, I think, 5 or 10 years back, when everything was working, then why we are coming with this kind of thing? What is the need of going with data science, right? Now, to understand that, let's understand a simple, very pictorial representation of the data that is generated per minute. Okay, data that is generated per minute. So you can see here. I hope everyone understand or knows about the platform Netflix. Everyone know YouTube. Everyone know Instagram, Microsoft Team is there, WhatsApp, Spotify, Twitter, Zoom call is there, Amazon e-commerce, TikTok is there, right? Everyone know about the platforms. But have you ever tried how much data it is generating per minute? So it's a data of 2020. Okay. It's a data of 2020 when the pandemic starts. So as soon as the pandemic start, Zoom gathered a very good number of customers. Microsoft Team gathered a very good number of customers. Even WhatsApp call, WhatsApp meetings. Okay. Twitter is also working very good at that time. Right. And to manage all of this data, to process all of this data, right? Someone has to do a specific task. Someone has to perform a specific job, right? Now, what job is? I'll just give you a simple example. Let's take Netflix. When we generate the account on Netflix, so Netflix asked for our choice that in which kind of you can say genre we are interested, correct? Either Hollywood, Bollywood, songs, what kind of language, yes or no? Right? Right. And as soon as you give all the initials to the Netflix comes up with certain results. With some good results, right? Yes or no? Have you ever told Netflix that no, I like this web series, I like this movie, I like this kind of series, I like Hollywood, Bollywood? Have you ever told? Never. But yes, whatever results Netflix generate, most of the time that are relevant to us. Correct? Most of the time relevant to the customer. This type of application is called recommendation. Recommendation engine. And the same recommendation engine, yes, due to the algorithm, right? Same recommendation engine, okay, little bit of difference, works in the e-commerce market as well. Flipkart, Amazon, right? Yeah, Myntra. Every e-commerce website, e-commerce company is using recommendation engine to recommend products without specifying any things to the customer. On your prior shopping, on your prior purchase, recommendation already generates some result, which is quite optimal to the customer. Getting my point? Yes or no? Right. Correct. Correct. No. So that is why a special, you can say, a specialized domain is generated. Okay. That we call as data scientists or machine learning engineers.